Hello Transformers fans, this is Optimus Smythe with another video review, and as you can see, today we are looking at Voyager Class Mixmaster. Yeah, a really, really nice figure. I'm very impressed. Been wanting him for quite a while, and I finally have him. He's a nice figure. He's got an awesome vehicle mode. It's kind of small, actually, the vehicle mode is. It's just a little bit longer than your average deluxe, and obviously it stands taller because it's a cement truck. You know, but it's not too small, I guess, but it's a little too small compared to, like, Voyager Ratchet and the Ironhide and things like that. I mean, look at how big he is when I hold him in my hand. Yeah, but it's a really nice cement truck. As you can see, it's, like, black, purple windows. Yeah, it's got a lot of translucent purple, even the lights. Light gray for the grill and bumper and smokestacks and mirrors. This mirror is kind of weird looking because it was packaged like that and it bent. And then the gas tanks down here are gray, and this ladder and all that. Yeah, the smokestacks, by the way, are on a ball and socket joint, so you got to kind of position them the way you like them to be. And be careful because sometimes they'll just go wherever you don't want them to, but it's okay. And then we got silver and purple on the cement barrel drum thing, whatever it is. Yeah, the cement barrel, I guess I'll call it. And it's really cool. It does not turn, however, and the reason for that is because it connects to these wheels and the thing over it with those white and red lines. It connects to them, and if it turned, well, they'd turn too. I wish they'd found a way to make those wheels fold up on the back instead of in the arms and make this so the arms can turn along this thing. They're not connected to that. They do connect to it, but they're not permanently connected. Yeah, and back here, as you can see, you can bring that down. Bring the ladder there or there. I think it's supposed to be here in vehicle mode. And the cement will pour down. This thing, I guess, goes like that. I think the cement drops down and then goes in. This thing goes back like that for part of the transformation. And I might have to have a two-part with this figure because he's got a third mode. Okay. My final rating for this, I'm going to say 9 out of 10, because it just needs to be bigger, that's all. But everything else, though, I really like. There's another thing I want to point out that I forgot. The wheels are, like, green. It's like a blackish green, mainly black, but it's, like, black green. It's really weird. But, oh well. Yeah, and he also didn't have his little dog thing on top of the hood. It's just got the Decepticon logo right there. So, yeah. So that's his vehicle mode. The cement truck, 9 out of 10. Now let's transform him before this gets too long. Alright, what you'll want to do first is, let's see, fold this thing up and put it like right there. Put this thing down, put the ladder right next to it. Now, next part, reach under and pull the wheels off like that, and as you can see, the whole barrel will split apart. Those are the arms. Bring them out like that. Now, this part can get kind of tricky. Bring the arm out like this. Bring the wheels this way, and then turn this thing to that side so you can bring the wheels back behind it. Like that. If you try to bring the wheels back there, it won't work because this will be in the way. And then bend that back. Open up the fingers and the thumb. So there, that arm's done. Now, where to put this is pretty much up to you. I just keep it under like that. And then just do the exact same with the other one. Okay, now that we're done with that, do this. Take the whole roof of the cab, and move it up like that, and then take the whole front part of the vehicle. Yeah, it's going to bring the legs with it, like that. Pull it up like that, it'll snap off, and then snap this whole front part and untab it. There's a whole assembly right here. Turn it around and we'll take care of that later. Detach the legs from one another. Now do this, take the gun and bring it back right here, and it'll tab, this hole will tab right into that little peg thingy. Right there, like that. And now, bend this up like a zigzag. Bend the body forward, like that much. and then bend this up like a zigzag and press it together like that. And but what you want to do first actually is take this thing, turn it around, put these things up, and then put this up against the side of the chest right near where the head is. Yeah, I'm definitely going to need to make a two-part review for this guy. And then just push it in. It doesn't really click in, it just goes in snug. Now with the legs, this is kind of tricky. While turning them up, bend them inwards, because that is how they're supposed to be right there, and then do the same with the other one. So basically the front tires should be on the inside of the thighs. Now take this, bend that little gray thing down, and it goes in that hole, but it doesn't go in so good. Just pretty much do it the best you can do, and he's got a truck there sitting right on his butt. Just kind of weird and kibblish, but oh well, who cares. Now with these things, take them and bend them back like that. And then bend his toes down, and do the same with the other one. So, one second. So there he's pretty much done. I like to have these parts of the barrel clearly visible on his head. You can pull his head up a little bit if you'd like. I meant clearly visible on his arms, head, you know, whatever. So, there you go. Bring his fingers out of it. He's not that bad to stand up. So there he is, there's Mixmaster. He's got really long, lanky arms, kind of like a gorilla, even though he's referred to as the Vampire Decepticon. Because he's, I don't know, they if you look at his head, he's got a batty type of look, a very vampiric, whatever, however you put it, look to his face. And he's got those long claws and long arms and like almost like they're wings, like a bat. Yeah, I really don't like these things being here. You can kind of hide them. You could put them back under the other part of the arm. But that kind of almost limit the posability and it'd kind of look weirder. But yeah, let's just set them up like that, actually. It's not that bad. So yeah. And the posability is just pretty much everywhere. I forgot to put these kneecap things out like that. The feet will bend that way. They'll turn at the thigh, and they'll also bend forward. They don't bend forward that much. He's kind of hunched over. His head is on a ball and socket joint, so that's good. These arms, I'm not going to even tell you how much they can bend. Like, they can do that, this, and that, and that, and that. There's like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, like 7 different hinges in his whole arm, so you can do whatever with them. So yeah, it's pretty crazy. He's got pretty crazy arms. Pretty crazy transformer. I like it though how the smokestacks stay right here. It kind of looks like Scrapper. Yeah, we really need a figure of Scrapper. And then he's got the gun right up there. But I'm already at 8 minutes, so I'm not going to even show you the third mode. That'll be in a part two. But that is him, the only new colors now. We see a lot more of, well, not much more of this grayish brown, a little, on the gun and the head. A lot more silver, orangish red parts, and maroon. A lot of, there's dark gray and then light gray everywhere. I like the robot mode, it's cool. I just don't really like those things. And I don't really like that. I mean, look at that, it's this big old Mack truck butt. Kind of weird. It doesn't transform. It's almost like Voyager Prime. Voyager Movie Prime. Yeah, but, oh well, it's not that bad, I guess. It's pretty cool. It's a nice figure. It looks just like how he's supposed to in the movie. Yeah, and you can also bend these things like that, so you could use them like shields for when someone's shooting at him. So that's cool. And the fingers can move out. I wish that this thumb was going in the other way, like it's supposed to be, but, oh well. So, yeah, that's Mixmaster. And he's pretty cool. I'd go out and get this figure. He's worth your money. Now stay tuned for part two, where I show you how to do his third mode, which is like the cannon artillery thingy. So that's it for now. Stay tuned for the next part of the review. Optimus Smythe signing off.